Hi, Casper from Encida here, and today we're going to look at how you get started with programming your power supply. There are many ways on how you can program a power supply, but what we're going to look at today is via the USB interface and the SCPI, or better known as skippy commands. So what we're going to start with is getting the power supply set up. So I've connected my power supply to the socket, and I've connected the USB cable to the USB entrance on the power supply. I'm now sitting into the power supply's manual, and we need to figure out how we get it connected to the computer. So I'm gonna scroll down and find how we're gonna configure it. Here is USB remote interface. So we can go down, here's the steps. So I've already connected the cable, and then I need to set the function setting F29, so I can go into the functions on the power supply. Find 29. And as we can see, it's already set to 3. To let the PC control the power supply, we need to use what is called a VESA driver, which stands for Virtual Instrument Software Architecture. And we can download that, for example, on the National Instruments website. When we've installed that, we can go into Safe. And in Safe, we need to add the device to our inventory. To add it to the inventory, I'm going to go to Inventory in the top left corner, add new equipment, and press VESA device. Because the power supply is the only VESA device that I've actually inserted into my computer, it automatically finds it. And it's the GV INSTEK PFR-100L. So I can just press load parameters and save. We now need to add some skippy commands to the device. So the easiest way to do that is drag in the device into a project, connect it, and then when it's connected, when you see that cable between the computer and the device, we can go over to the right and press add command. Here we get a menu where we can add the command and give it a name. So let's take a very basic command such as reset. So I input the command, the name, I can then go to details, this is reset, and then test command. And here we have a passed command, and then we can just press test command. And we get the response from the device. We can save, and we can save and put a new one. And for power supplies, we probably want to set, for example, the voltage. So we need to go in back into the manual and find a set voltage command. So we go to the command list. And usually the manual has a command list with all the commands. And then it's just about finding the correct command. So here under source, we have source voltage level immediate amplitude, which is on page 94. So here on the page, we have our voltage set, and we can see description sets or queries the voltage level in volts. And here we have the syntax. So I'm just gonna copy that syntax and then go back to save, and then paste the command in the command. And we're gonna give it a name, set voltage. And then under test command, you can see that we now have the command. Then we can set the variable, so we can say, for example, 5, and then test the command. We get a response, and we can see that it's actually changed to 5 volts. Then we can just set it back. So when you are satisfied with your command and the name and you've tested it properly, you can just press save. Then you can open up commands, and here you have a list of all your different commands. I've just put in some extra commands, and to use the commands in our measurement sequence, we go over to the sequence. So we have two different tracks that we can use for our VESA device. The first is macro, which is sending a bunch of commands to the device, and measurement, which is measuring a certain parameter. For example, here it could be the voltage multiple times during a measurement. So let's drag in a macro, and to set up the different commands, you just press on the add command and then the command that you want in. Here, for example, we can set the voltage, the current, and turn the output on. And this doesn't work because we need to set the parameter for each command. So over in properties, we have the parameters, and here we can say we want to have 10 volts at 1 ampere, and then turn the output on. And then in the next step, we can again add the macro and then turn the output off. And then to test it, we can either test the macro trick alone by pressing the test, or we can run the sequence. So let's try and run the sequence. And as you could see, the device reacted to our commands, changed the voltage, the current, set the output to on, and then in the next step, it set the output to off. And that's how you set up and use skippy commands and remotely control your power supply. See you next time.